A very good evening, sir. Myself Abhishek Chaudhary. I welcome you to the College Duniya platform. And this is basically our thoughts on education. And I'll be asking you some questions. And the very first question is, sir, you have held key positions at education institutes throughout your professional career. So what are the key factors that keep you connected with the education sector?
Right. Thank you very much, Abhishek, for giving me this opportunity. The biggest thing what I feel here is the challenges. Challenges to shape a student who is very raw and our always attempt is we should make him a polished person, a good doctor, a good dentist. So the challenge is the students are coming from the different backgrounds. Some of them may not be very much familiar even with the current basic language what we use for the teaching is English. Some of them may be from the Hindi background. They have throughout their school life they have a teaching in the Hindi language. So now the environment is a bit changed because all the books they are in English. Apart from that, there are several other changes from the school life. So the biggest challenge is how we can modulate, we can modify, we can shape that mind to a very good professional, very good dentist, very good doctor. So this is a big challenge which always keeps me connected with education. And every time, every student is a new person for me and they give a new challenge to me that yes, I am different, now it's your task, how you make me a good doctor, a good dentist.
That's very nice, sir. So moving to the next question. So the education system in India and other foreign countries are structured very differently. So in your experience, what can an inbound student gain from studying here in your country?
Alright. As far as dental education in India is concerned, all the dental colleges, they are giving education as per the curriculum which is prescribed or given by the Dental Council of India. But yes, we focus on wholesome development of the students. When a student takes admission in our college, it's not about we are teaching him the dentistry or her the dentistry. We are giving the opportunity to sharpen other skills. We are giving opportunities to learn dance also, to engage in the extracurricular activities also. We are providing them that teaching process for the singing, dancing, and apart from that, we are doing the same. Then day to day, we are in other competitions also. So we are focusing on a wholesome development of a student. And apart from that, I can say one of the colleges which are having a good patient base is Hyderabad College of Dental Sciences also. See, when we are taking admission, any student takes an admission at Dental or Medical College, prime concern is whether he will be learned on the patients or not. So we are having 300 plus of it. Apart from that, we are having our own multi-specialty Srinivas Hospital, which is a general hospital. So students get training in the field of medical science also. Other than that, we are having a research lab by the name of SCSRD, Srinivas Center for Scientific Research and Development. There we have a world-class research facility. We are having our own RT-PCR lab, which is NMEA-accredited. So I really don't think other dental colleges, many dental colleges, are having such type of facility in campus. This gives the training to the student not only in the dentistry but for the allied sciences as well as they train the student or they engage the student in the extracurricular activities so that they can get the type of the registration also.
Okay, that's really nice, sir. So, how does the curriculum of your university ensure the best practice of
dentistry? Right, as I told you in earlier question only, curriculum wise, yes, across the India, we are following the Dental Council of India prescribed curriculum, but that curriculum gives us a minimum requirement. We are never focused on the minimum, we try to give the student the maximum. And as I told, we are having a good patient base, we are having a research facility, means our labs are one of the best labs in India. So laboratory wise, we give when the basic sciences comes, we are giving the student the best training for the laboratories. When it comes to the patients, we are having a good patient base, we are giving a good clinical training to the students. So that gives us an upper hand compared to the other dental colleges in India.
That's very great, sir. So moving to the next question. Any insights into how your university could be more welcoming to students of different races or economic backgrounds?
Of course, we don't discriminate among the students with respect to their caste, age, and grade. All the students, irrespective of their background, they are welcome. And whenever a student is noticed or they approach us that they are not from a financially strong family, we have a facility to give them the scholarship. See, fees, yes, it is important because we are parents, finance, and parents, or the institute. But at the same time, it doesn't come in between their education. Whenever needed, and they approach us, they need some financial support, our institute, our management is always there to support them financially. As I told, we give scholarships also. If required, we give them some time to pay the fees also. It's not like, okay, it is starting of the year only, they need to pay the entire amount, and otherwise we will not allow them for the continuing their session. We consider there if there is some genuine request, if there is some genuine problem, we consider it and we provide them to school.
Okay, that's really great, sir. So the next question is, what do you think your roles and responsibilities to the college and the students are?
Okay, of course, my basic role is looking after the day-to-day activities in the institution. So I need to see their curriculum also, they are supposed to be taught in their respective years. It's with the pace of the time or not, because we have a time for 1 year. For each year, we need to conduct the university exam. Before the university exam, students need to cover 3 internal assessments also. So I need to see whether their syllabus, what faculty members we are teaching them, is according to time need or not. If requires some extra hours, we provide them. Whether the facilities for their studies, like research, library, some other books are required, new books are required, or some new material is there which we need to prepare for our students, I need to see that availability also. Other than that, when they are staying in the hostel, they are facing any problem in the hostel, or if there are any issues with their health, when the new students are coming, are they having any some homesickness, something other issues? So I usually take record of all the other things, all these things, whether students are coming up with a new environment or when some new students are there. When they become second year, third year, final year students, whether they are ready for their future life, what they think they need to pursue for their post-graduation course, or they want to start with practice. At the same time, we discuss about what is their future plans. Accordingly, we mentor them, we coach them that, okay, you start thinking direction, start reading these books if you want to pursue for your PG course. So it's overall arrangement, I can say management identity for the student level for their day-to-day routine life.
Okay, wow, sir. So what do you think should be the college's top priority over the next 10 years?
The biggest priority right now, particular to India, I think is research. There is a lot of scope for the research in India because still, compared to other countries, I can say we are not following the good practices what other countries are following. Maybe a financial concern is there. Still, we are among the developing or about to develop countries, and materials, many materials, we are not able to, companies are not able to produce in India. They are not able to provide it. So when this manufacturing will start for some material which may be suitable for the Indian environment or Indian culture will come, of course the cost will be reduced. And there are many other things which we need to, or processes are there which we need to simplify. We need to make them more patient friendly, more doctor friendly. So there is a lot of area for the research, but there is a lot of scope for the research. So research in dentistry for the therapies or the treatment as well as for the materials, it should be one of the top priorities in coming years.
Nice to know, sir. So what would you like people to know about your college that you give us?
I probably, there are many things which many people may not be knowing, that we are among the first dental colleges in Jharkhand, those who have CBCT, that is a Cone-beam computer tomography machine, and the college, most of the dental colleges I know are having, but we are among the first in Jharkhand, those who have that machine. And that is one of the very important instrument, equipment, I can say, with respect to patient treatment, as well as training of the students is concerned. Other than that, our faculty, we are one of the highest qualified and experienced faculty members among the dental colleges. We have OPD of nearly 300 plus patients per day, which gives a good patient exposure to the student, which is students as well as for the postgraduate students. Other than that, we have a good hospital facility. As I said, we have facilities for the extracurricular activities of the student. We provide home studying training, we provide dancing, singing, and we have a multi-gym, good canteen, mess facility. If somebody doesn't like the mess food one day, because many of these small employees in the canteen, which is a Broadway or cultural arts open. Other than that, we have in-campus ATM facilities. We have, as I told, we have our own multi-specialist in mass of students. Our own blood bank we have. We have our own pharmacy college, which is coming. So it's like a, I can say, it's a mini city, I can say, within this campus. The student need not to go outside to purchase anything. We have our own grocery shop. We have our own travel arrangement within the campus only. We have a beauty parlor for some of the girls. So all the facilities are available for a student, which they need in their daily life. So they can fully focus on the their studies. Other than that, whenever they need, we have a facility for the education or recreational stuff.
We just are taking care of all those.
So yes,
very best bits. So what do you see as your college's greatest strengths?
Yeah, as I already mentioned, I'll say there are three aspects. First one, my faculty members. As I said, they are one of the highest qualified and trained faculty members. Secondly, one of the best infrastructures. And third one, the bigger one, the support of our management, that within the education, let me say, the finance will not be a problem. So our madam is always ready to pay whenever we say, yes, this is needed for the student. We always try to equip our laboratories, our library with the good books, with the new equipment, so that our students will be at par with the new development facilities as far as their dental education is concerned.
Okay, that's great, sir. So what are some of the biggest challenges you see, both for higher education in general and for your college specifically?
Keeping up with the advancements is one of the biggest challenges. Day to day life, new things are coming. As I said, research is a priority and research is going on. So every other day we'll come to know this new thing has come. Now, giving the information, educate the students about the new developments, new advancements and new techniques is one of the big challenges. Because if we want to teach them, we want to educate them, we want to train them with those advancements, our faculty members should also get the training lesson. So we need to see, yes, our faculties are getting trained in them or not. We always encourage them to participate in the CPE programs, participate in the conferences. At the same time, we also encourage the students to participate in the conferences and seminars and to bring them. So keeping up in the pace with the advancement in industry is one of the challenges, I think.
Yeah, really, sir. So how do you tend to establish a healthy relation and environment in your college?
One of the biggest key for the healthy environment is communication.
Yes.
I always try there should be a good communication among the students, students and the faculty members and between the faculty members. So we conduct the regular meetings. See, the teachers, like first year teachers, they will be in the first year meetings. At the same time, even at the administrative level, other levels, we engage other senior teachers also, other faculty members also, they should also talk to the students. Many times, they may not be telling some problems to their teachers, those who are teaching them. Maybe they are in some language problem or they are having some other issues. So we try to create a mentor-mentee type of relationship. So communication, I see as a bridge which can give us a very good strength and remove the hurdles and barriers between the students and the faculty.
Yes, really, really, sir. So any suggestions you would like to give to the current youth and the aspiring students?
I think hard work is the key to success. And hard work with the coach, a good coach on mentor is necessary to achieve your goal. It's too hard work, but also under the guidance of a good coach.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Thanks a lot.